find out more about what happens when a no-contact bond provision is put in place after being charged with domestic violence, this is the video for you. Don't forget to click like and subscribe so you get all of our videos in the domestic violence series. So no contact means just that. You can't have contact with the person who is named in your bond condition. But it's more far-reaching. For example, it's on you, not on them. And what I mean by that is if you are at a location and they show up after you, they don't have to leave, you do. It can be a public place, the grocery store, Walmart, it doesn't matter. If you have a perfectly reasonable reason to be present, you still are the one with the bond condition. And if you violate it, meaning that this person sees you and calls the police, you can be rearrested and put in jail without a bond for a felony charge. So it's very, very, very serious. Now, no contact provisions also mean that you can't call this person, you can't text this person, you can't have someone on your behalf try and contact this person. Any sort of communication, be it in writing, be it orally, be it electronically, anything at all that you do to communicate with them can result in you being rearrested for violating the bond condition and then being put in jail with no bond and charged with a felony. If you've got a no contact provision, it's something where the sooner a lawyer can get involved to help you get it modified, the better it is that you're not in danger of being rearrested. If you are worried about your bond condition or have a no contact provision that needs modifying, fill out our online submission or give us a call and we'd be happy to give you a consultation to review your domestic violence bond condition.